Hi, Odooers. At Stealthy Wood, we want to avoid having underselling products in stock, but we don't want to stop offering them. To keep them in our catalog, we will implement the dropshipping strategy. Instead of having this product on hand, dropshipping will allow our suppliers to ship it directly to the customers. As a result, we will never see or handle the item, which helps minimize risk since we don't have anything in stock that could lose value overnight. New products will also be less expensive for us as they won't require investment before they can be sold. Then we can offer a wider variety of products than what would be possible if we had to buy and store all of them. Finally, all the hassle of packing products to prepare them for shipment will be done by the supplier, not us, decreasing the amount of work our staff needs to perform. Very convenient. So let's see how this works in Stealthy Wood's database. All right, here I am on my database. The first thing we're going to do is go to the purchase application, configuration, settings, and activate the dropshipping option. So it's going to be at the bottom of our settings page, dropshipping right here underneath the logistics section. I already have it activated, as you can see here. So let's go ahead and apply this route to one of our products. So I'm going to go to products again, and I'm going to search for my pedal bin, okay? If I can spell it correctly. Now we're going to go to the pedal bin, click on edit, and there are a couple of really important things that we need to set on the product template in order for this flow to work. So first of all, we need to go to the inventory tab and be sure that drop ship is selected. It's not going to be selected by default, even though you have the option activated. You do need to go to the product template and activate it. Okay, so I've already done that, but something else I need to be sure that I've done as well is to add a vendor under the purchase section, which I have not. Okay, so if we're drop shipping, we of course are buying the product from our vendor who will send it directly to our customer. Okay, so we need to add a vendor here in order for that purchase order to be automatically generated. So let's go ahead and add a vendor. Gemini Furniture, I'm gonna add a price as well. Then we're going to save and close. If you do have multiple vendors for this product, the vendor that will be selected for the drop shipping will be the first one in the list. So you will need to drag and drop the vendor you would like to use for this flow. So let's go ahead and click on save. Now let's jump over to the sales application and create a quotation for this product. So I'm going to choose one of my customers. Let's go ahead and select Brandon Freeman. Okay, and then we're going to add that product, the pedal bin. All right, now that we've done that, let's go ahead and save and confirm. And once it's confirmed, you're going to notice right away that a delivery order is not created as it would be in a regular buy flow, okay, or for the buy route. But a purchase order is generated. So let's go ahead and go back to the purchase application and go to the purchase order or the request for quotation that was generated automatically. Because again, we do need to buy this product from the vendor who will send it directly to our customer. So we're going to click here. I have the one pedal bin. I can go ahead and confirm this. All right, we have all the information we need, even our confirmation date, the company, everything. So we have everything here, and then we can receive the products. All right, and when we receive the products, we're gonna see that the operation type is dropship. Okay, and we have all the other information as we would on a regular receipt, but the operation is dropship. So let's go ahead and validate this. I'm going to apply the done quantity. All right, so when this is done, when this is validated, what we're gonna do is actually go back to our sales order, because I just wanna point out something here. Now that I have validated the receipt for that purchase order, I'm gonna see that a delivery order has been created on the sales order. But when I click on it, we'll see that the delivery order is already done. Okay, just like that. So it's a really simple and easy flow once you have your product template set up correctly. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. And if I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.